Welcome, welcome. Thanks for clicking on this video and taking a good step towards civil engineering knowledge. In this video, we are going to talk about four important tools everyone on the site must know. Whether you're a site supervisor, an engineer, a builder, or just a person getting your house constructed, you have to keep an eye on your labor and check whether they're doing the work properly. In this video, the tools shown are going to help you in your supervision and get your work done properly. So, let's begin. So the first instrument every engineer must know is a plumb bob. This is the weight, this is the header, and this is the string at which the weight is suspended.
It is used as a vertical reference line to level an object vertically. There should be a thin gap between the object and the weight.
So as I place this header at any surface, or I can place this at the top, and since this weight has a pointer down, I can use it to lower it at any surface down and make a marking on the ground.
You get to buy the weight and the header in one pack. You have to buy the string separate. They are available in different sizes and the most commonly used on site are 2, 4 and 6. Note, as the size increases, so does the weight. It is used during masonry work to raise a wall vertically even.
So the next instrument every engineer I feel must know is the leveling pipe. So as the name suggests, this is a leveling tool, but it is also used to mark or as a reference. So there are markings made on this door 2 feet from the top at this point and this point. I'm going to go inside my leveling pipe on these two marks and check if the water head is coinciding on these markings. So I place this part here and this part here, and I'm waiting for the water to stabilize. Point to be noted that I shouldn't stamp the pipe at any point anywhere, neither there should be any air bubbles in the pipe. Once the water has leveled, then I will check if both the marks are coinciding with the water head. If they are coinciding, then our door is leveled.
Level pipes are bought in a bundle of 30 meters, or they are available in cut pieces of 5 or 6 meters. In this example, you can see a marking is made on the pole and the wall of the sump is being raised to that level.
The next instrument I suggest every engineer must know is a spirit level.
This is how a spirit level looks. Its body is made of metal, generally aluminium. It consists of 3 hollow glass tubes fit in the plastic or fiber frame. The glass tubes are filled with ether or alcohol, partially leaving enough space for an air bubble. Ether or alcohol is filled as it is free for the bubble to move in this liquid while compared to water. Horizontal leveling, vertical leveling, or inclined leveling of 45 degrees can be done with this instrument. The bubble should be in between the two parallel lines, which indicates that the object is leveled.
Engineering teaches us many things, and one of the things I learned from engineering is magic. Yes, there's a magic to place the spirit level on the slope without it slipping. So let's see how to do it. See guys, how it's on the slope without slipping? So this is the magic. Guys, I'm just kidding. That doesn't work here. The only magic we have is physics. And here the magic is the magnet inside this spirit level. So these are the markings that show that it has a magnet. That's why sticking to any metal surface, let it be straight or a slope, the magnet is strong enough to hold to it.
Some of its uses are, it is used to check if the door is vertically leveled or horizontally leveled, or since it has a magnet, it can be placed on shutter plates, and leveling can be done during columns or slab construction.
The next instrument we are going to talk about is the builder square. So this is how a builder square looks.
It is made of aluminium.
So as you can see, it has a long arm and a short arm. It has readings on the outer and inside of the scale. So these readings can be used accordingly for outer and inner measurements. The readings are given on both sides. This is the longer arm, and the maximum reading given is top is 23 inches and down it's 21 inches. Here at the last we have 22 inches reading. If you want to measure from the end of this arm, then the readings are given in between, and the last reading is given under 2, that is 22 inches, and obviously under this one will come the 23 inches. This is the shorter arm, and the maximum reading on the shorter arm is 14 inches on the top and 12 inches on the bottom. Being a perfect L, it is used to measure 90 degrees angle at corners or intersections.
One of its practical use is seen while construction of stairs to measure and mark risers and threads. Also, it can be used to check if walls are intersecting perpendicularly.
Hey guys, hope you found the video helpful.
This is just a sneak peek of the videos about to come in this channel. There are many videos going to be related to theory and practical of civil engineering. Their topics going to be covered like how a beam is constructed, how columns are constructed, how slab is constructed, and how plastering is done, how a brickwork is done. And also there are going to be topics like related to steel structure design. So don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring the bell icon.
Do share your views and ideas in the comment section about anything that could be done even more better. This is YSJ.
This is Muhammad Abdul Bari.
Signing off.
Thank you.